Okay, this is the notes page for inverses for Unit 1, where we just look at the graphical method and we go over some definitions that we'll return to in next unit. Given the function of a one-to-one function, given the graph of a one-to-one function, sketch its inverse and compare the relationship between the domain and range of a function to its inverse. So remember, a function f defined on domain D is 1-to-1 if each value of f of x corresponds to exactly one value of x in D. And so 1-to-1 functions pass the horizontal line test. Okay, so earlier in the semester we talked about what a function is. A function, the x's have to be different. And the way to test that is with the vertical line test. All right, a one-to-one function, the y's have to be different as well. And that test is the horizontal line test. And the reason we need to know what a one-to-one function is because we're talking about inverses today, inverse functions, and only one-to-one functions have inverses. So if f is a one-to-one function on domain x with range y, then f has a unique inverse, and the symbol for an inverse is that, so f and the inverse of f. And the inverse has the domain y and the range x, so they switch places, such that the inverse function, if I put the original function into that inverse function, you get x. It's called function composition. We haven't gotten there yet. We'll learn that. For all x and x, and if I put the inverse into the f function, it'll become y for all y and y. Okay, so you really don't need to know that definition. All you need to know right now is that only one-to-one functions have inverses, and the domain and the range, they switch, and we're going to talk a lot more about that. Okay, so that's this picture here. All right, so with this example, it'll come a little bit more clear. Okay, so example one, let the following graph represent the one-to-one function f of x. The domain of f, this is f, is bracket -2 to 7, and you can see that. Here's -2 and here's 7, so that's the domain, and the range is 0 to 3. Here's the lowest y value, 0, all the way up to 3. It says graph f to the -1, so that means graph the inverse and determine the domain and range. Okay, so I had to fix this graph a little bit. Alright, so here's what you would want to do. You want to pull off a few ordered pairs from the graph and write them down, and there's an infinite amount of ordered pairs, but let's just use the three that are given, -2, 0, 2, 2, and 7, 3. And so then here's the big deal here. To graph the inverse, all you have to do is switch these ordered pairs, because the domain of the function is the range of the inverse, and the range of the function is the domain of the inverse. So I'll just switch these ordered pairs. 2, 2 doesn't change, and then 7, 3 becomes 3, 7. And then if you graph it, it's going to look like this. So 0, negative 2, and then 2, 2, and then 3, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have to go off the graph a bit. And then when you connect the dots, you kind of need to know that this graph is going to be symmetrical over this line y equals x. And that'll help you figure out the shape of the graph. So we don't we want to this curve here to be symmetrical. So that's how I know that the curve is going to look like that. All right, so that's another fact about inverses. Number one, the x's and y's, the ordered pairs switch. Number two, f and the inverse are symmetrical about the line y equals x. And three, from the definition, in answer to the question, it says determine the domain and range. This is just three ordered pairs from the domain and range. All right, the domain is up here, -2, 7. That was for the domain of the function. This is the range of the function. And we know that inverses, the domain and ranges switch. So the inverse domain is going to be 0, 3, because that was the range of the function. And the range of the inverse is going to be -2, 7. And you can check it out if you look at it in red. The range goes from -2 up to 7, and the domain goes from 0 to 3. So that checks out. All right, so the second example. Let the following graph represent the one-to-one function f of x. The domain of f is -1, 2. This time 2 has a parenthesis. You can see there's a little hole there. And the range is -3 to 1.5. Same thing. So this point is not really a point, it's a hole, but it's an open boundary. We have to put those in there. Okay, I've already given you the ordered pairs. Okay, so it says graph the inverse, so the easiest thing to do to graph is to go ahead and just switch the ordered pairs on your paper. So -1, -3 becomes -3, -1. Then you have -2.50, then you have 0, 1.5, and then you have 1.52. Okay, so these points, -3, -1, is that where maybe negative three would be about right here. And then -2.5, which is right here, zero, which is right here, and then 0, 1.5, and then 1.52. Now, remember this 2 and this 1.5, that's a hole. So that means that this 1.52 is also going to be a hole. And to check my work, it's really hard for me to see these numbers, I'm going to sketch the line y equals x just to make sure it looks like what I expect it to look like. It's got to be symmetrical about this line. Okay. And when I connect the dots, sure looks symmetrical to me. And I would just check my work. There's a hole here, hole here. So that is the proper graph of the inverse. Okay, and then it says determine the domain and the range. So the inverse domain is the range of the function, and the range of the inverse is the domain of the function. And let's make parentheses here and here. Okay, so on the back we've got a couple for you to try, so you should try those and then come back and see how you did. We were supposed to graph the inverse and determine the domain and range. So I'm going to write down the ordered pairs for the given function. There are an infinite amount of ordered pairs, but we'll just need to write down the ones that are given. If you're not given those order pairs, just pick three off your graph, off the graph yourself. All right, and so then the inverse, we're just going to switch those order pairs. Okay, so we get -1, -2, 2.40, 3, 2. So -1, -2, I've got to go down a little bit. -1, -2, okay. And then 0, 2.4, or 2.40 would be here's 2.5, here's 2.4, and then 3, 2. And none of these are holes, so I'm going to connect the dots. And first I'm going to draw this line here. This is the line y equals x, just to make sure it looks right. Looks like this point right here looks a little bit off. Okay, I had to stop the video because I found a mistake, and rather than erase that and act like I'm perfect, if this were a seated classroom, I would use this opportunity to try to help you kind of think through things. And I found my mistake because I used the properties of inverses. Okay, so this looked a little off, so I drew the y equals x. And I know that this has to be symmetrical. And one of the things I didn't tell you is one of the ways you can test the symmetry is if you draw a perpendicular line through these two points. See that? This point should hit that point if you draw a perpendicular line. So see, that works. This point, if I draw a perpendicular line, that works. At this point, if I draw a perpendicular line, that does not work. And so what happened was I wrote down negative 2, negative 1, when it should have been negative 2, 1. So that means that this is going to be 1, negative 2. All right, so now I'm going to draw that. And now I've got that perpendicular situation. Okay, so now I can connect the dots, and I want to kind of have the same sort of shape. So this is a little bit more curved here. So you might want to actually get another point off of the graph just to make sure you can get the shape. So I'll just use this chance to tell you that a lot of times students will turn in work where it's just very obviously wrong. And they get so focused on doing something, they don't remember how to check their work. So this was a silly mistake. But rather than me erase it and act like I know everything, you know, you're going to make mistakes. It will happen. And so you have to check your work and use critical thinking and figure out the silly mistake that you made. And most of the mistakes that you make are going to involve negatives. Okay, so the domain for this, and the range for the inverse. The domain starts at 1 and ends at 3, and both 1 and 3 are x coordinates that are points, so they are bracketed. The range starts down here at negative 2 and goes up. The highest point is 2. So that's the domain and range. All right, and then the second one, I've got these ordered pairs. Let's see, negative 1, 0.5, 0, 1, and 1, 2. And so the inverse, we'll switch those. 0.5, negative 1, 1, 0, 2, 1. Okay, and so then we're going to graph that. 2, 1, 1, 0. 0.5, negative 1. And now look at this. Notice that this goes on forever and ever, and that goes on forever, ever and ever. So the domain of f is all real numbers. And the range of f, this looks like it's going to hug, remember exponentials? It's going to hug this line y equals 0. So the range is going to be parentheses 0 to infinity. Okay, so when it's time to graph this, let's think about the domain and range of the inverse. They switch, remember, so the domain of the inverse is going to be parentheses 0 to infinity, and the range of the inverse is going to be negative infinity to infinity. And so what happens is, if you go back to remember about horizontal asymptotes, this has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. I can kind of see it's leveling off there, which means not only do the domain and range switch places, so do the asymptotes. If f has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0, then the inverse has a vertical asymptote of x equals 0. And that's going to help me get this graph. It goes on forever and ever, so you shouldn't just stop here. This is going to hug the x-axis, I mean the y-axis, the equation x equals 0. And to me that looks like it could be exponential, and the inverse of an exponential function is something called a logarithmic function. Okay, so that is it for inverses. Remember the three properties. One, the order pairs switch. Two, the inverses are symmetrical about the line y equals x, and you can check your work by drawing little perpendicular lines from point to point. And three, the domain and ranges switch.